Hello my dear students, good morning. Now we will discuss about balancing of redox reaction by oxidation number method actually. So previously the same balancing of redox reaction we discussed by using ion electron method or half reaction method. Means we separated oxidation half and reduction half. We written two columns and we balanced by using some rules. Right? So here also same way. We will balance redox reaction in oxidation number method. So same here also we have to follow some rules. So what we have to do first means, first they will give redox reaction. So in that redox reaction, which atoms undergone oxidation or reduction you have to identify. How? By knowing the change in oxidation number. So first point is in redox reaction identify what you have to do, identify atoms in which change in oxidation state happened. This we have to observe first. So what we have to do first, in redox reaction identify atoms in which change in oxidation state occurred or happened. Okay, so afterwards second point, identify that oxidation half and reduction half. This you have to do. So two points. First thing, in redox reaction identify atoms in which change in oxidation state happened in both reactant side and product side. Okay, in reactant side and product side for the same atom, if you have similar oxidation state or same oxidation state, so that particular species or atom is not undergoing any oxidation or reduction. That is the meaning. Okay, you know already oxidation state increased oxidation state reduced reduction. So that's why we have to identify the change in oxidation states first. Afterwards identify oxidation half and reduction half. Okay, next third one, identify, okay, so identify total change in charge in both oxidation half and reduction half. This we have to do. Third point. So first rule you understood, and second rule hope so you can do this, because we did in previous also. So how to separate oxidation half and reduction half, this you know already. And this one is very important. Identify total change in charge in both oxidation half and reduction half. This is the most important thing. And the fourth one is balance remaining atoms except oxygen and hydrogen by using some suitable number. This we have to do. Sir, all atoms we have to balance, sir, means no. In which that particular oxidation occur or in which particular reduction occur, there only we will use this point. Okay, this particular point when we will multiply with the suitable number, means in which particular atom oxidation happened or reduction happened, in that particular only we will use some numbers and we will multiply some numbers and we will multiply with those numbers. Okay, in reactant side or product side where required. Okay, so as I mentioned in previous many times, like P4 is there, here some PH3 is there, we multiply with 4 like this. Getting what I'm saying? So very, very important, you must know all these things. So you have to write all these 4 points first. Okay, so one more point, two more points we have, those points also we will discuss, and very next we will discuss about some examples for balancing of redox reaction in oxidation number method. Got it, sir? So this is a very, very important, you must know. So please write down all these points. Okay, so now I'll go for next point. Can I? Okay, so how many rules we discussed? 4. First, identify in which atoms oxidation state changed, that you have to identify, and you have to identify oxidation half and reduction half, and you have to identify total charge difference in both oxidation half and reduction half, that we have to do. And next, 4 points M. How to balance remaining atoms except oxygen and hydrogen, remaining atoms we have to balance by using some suitable number, by multiplying with a suitable number. Where the number of atoms are less, there we will multiply with suitable number. Correct? So those 4 points you have to keep it in your mind. So next is 5th point. This is very, very important. Equalize total change in charge in both oxidation half and reduction half. In reduction half, both we have to do this. So the total charge in oxidation half and total charge in reduction half, we will have something, some number. So we have to equalize. How? Mainly or majorly we will do one thing. We will cross multiply the total charge change in oxidation half and reduction half. I will explain very clearly. The change in charge in oxidation half, that particular number, if suppose 4, with 4 we will multiply reduction half, both reactants and products. Understanding? Same way, in reduction half, if the total charge change is 3, with 3 we will multiply oxidation half in both the reactant side and product side, we will do that. Understood, sir? Very simple, sir. Many times we will do in that way only. Simple, generalized manner I will say. In oxidation half, if total charge change is some x, with x we will multiply reduction half, means like the cross multiply electrons, we use it like that. In reduction half, total charge change is y, then with y we will multiply oxidation half in both reactant side and product side, like that we will do. Equalize total charge, okay, total change in charge, change charge, okay, in both oxidation half and reduction half. By how? Mainly, in general, how we will do that? In general, how we will do? By cross multiplying the with the change of total charge in oxidation half and reduction half. Okay, so in general, how we will do that, you write down in brackets in your notes like this. Okay, so in general, we will equalize charge, write down like this. Equalize charge by cross multiplication. By cross multiplication of charge difference or total charge difference. Charge difference in both oxidation and reduction half. This is very, very important. Okay, so this is the 5th point. Next, last and final, is what? Means if ionic redox reactions, means in redox reaction, in reactants and products, ions are present, then we have to balance oxygen and hydrogen. Otherwise, normally we can balance oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, they will balance automatically. But if ions are present, what are present? If ions are present in both reactants and products, in reactants and products, then what we have to do? Then we have to balance hydrogen and oxygen. In what manner? In two manners. You know that already. Oxygen balancing just by adding number of water molecules. By adding number of water molecules. Hope you are understanding all these things. In fifth point, we are equalizing total charge difference in oxidation half and reduction half. In sixth point, if ions are present in both reactants and products, then we have to balance hydrogen and oxygen in following way. How? Means oxygen balancing. This you know already. Oxygen balancing in ion electron method we discussed. By adding water molecules, whichever the number of oxygens are less, there we will add water molecules. Correct? So that we will use oxygen balancing. And second thing is, how to balance hydrogen? Hydrogen balances two ways. One is in acidic medium. In acidic medium and in basic medium. Acidic medium means we use H plus ions, right? Basic medium means we use OH minus ions, right? So in acidic medium, how to balance? We know that already. How to balance? Just add number of H plus ions where less hydrogens are present. Okay? In which side number of hydrogens are less present, that side we have to add H plus ions. Okay? Just please refer that you can understand acidic medium how we balance hydrogens, and in basic medium how we will balance, hydrogens. You can understand. Okay, just please revise the previous class. Okay, so in acidic medium add H plus ions. In basic medium add OH minus ions. But not in less side. More side you have to add OH minus ions. Add OH minus ions in more number of hydrogens side. And add water molecules in opposite side. I told you. So please revise that. And what I said? Add OH minus ions in opposite side. I told you that already. So these are the total points what we have to balance redox reaction. In this oxidation number method. Understood, sir, everyone? So these are very, very important. How we will equalize charge, in example you can understand. So in general, how we will equalize charges? By cross multiply. Okay, with particular change in reduction half and particular change in oxidation half, we will cross multiply that point. And if ions are present in both reactants and product side, then we have to balance hydrogen and oxygen by adding number of water molecules to balance oxygen. And to balance hydrogen, that depends on medium. Acidic medium means we will add H plus ions in which side the number of hydrogens are less. Which side means in reactant side or product side, like that. How to balance H plus hydrogens in basic medium? We will add OH minus ions in which side hydrogens are more. In opposite side, we will add same number of water molecules. Means if you added 2 OH minus ions, 2 water molecules you will add in the product side. Like that. Okay, let's discuss some example now. Please write it down, all these things. Then I will give you one example. Now we will discuss about one example. So this is the redox reaction I was given. K2Cr2O7 plus HCl gives rise to KCl plus CrCl3 plus Cl2 plus H2O. So first I written oxidation states already. So I hope you written all 6 points what we discussed. In our first point, if you see, identify oxidation state changes, okay, in reactant side and product side, that we have to do. So here I written already, so it's a chromium is a plus 6, because you know this already, chromium 2x plus 2 into plus 1 plus 7 into minus 2 is equal to 0, this you know already, right? Then 2x equal to plus 12, then x equal to plus 6. This is a chromium oxidation state. Here chromium oxidation state in CrCl3. CrCl3 means x plus 3 into minus 1 is equal to 0, then x equal to plus 3. Everybody knows. So why is there chlorine minus there? Means chromium is a metal. Metal have a positive. So chlorine is more electronegative than chromium or not? Certainly chromium has plus 3 here. So this conversion to this conversion, chromium plus 6 to chromium plus 3. So that is a reduction half, because oxidation state decreased from plus 6 to plus 3. So I identified that. And one more thing I identified that. What is that? Here chlorine minus 1, here chlorine 0. Here chlorine minus 1 only. So this to this I cannot compare, because no change in oxidation state. Okay. So here chlorine minus 1 converted to 0. So this is called what? Oxidation. Oxidation half. Oxidation half this one. Okay. So this one oxidation half and chromium conversion is reduction half. Then why was not considered this potassium and all, sir? Means I have my reasons. You should know those reasons. Here K plus, here K plus. Here Cl minus, here Cl minus. So HCl to KCl I cannot compare as oxidation or reduction. Okay, a same story here H plus and here H plus. So I cannot compare HCl with water also. So I have one particular thing. What is that? One is reduction half and one is oxidation half. What is reduction half and what is oxidation half? Very simple. So here K2Cr2O7 converted to CrCl3. This is oxidation half, sorry, reduction half, and HCl converted to Cl2. This is what? Oxidation half. So very simple. So here chromium is the plus 6, here chromium is the plus 3. So plus 6 converted to plus 3. So this is what? Reduction half. And HCl converted to Cl2. This is oxidation half. Oxidation half. Because here chlorine is minus 1. Here chlorine oxidation state is 0. Okay. So our 2 points over, I think. Okay, we separated. Then why you was not written KCl and water, sir? I will write at the end. I will balance those also, oxygens and hydrogens. Okay. So first I took only reduction half and oxidation half like this. Now our next point is balance other than oxygen and hydrogen. So here 2 chromiums, here 1 chromium. So I'll put 2 here first. So what is the total change in charge? Here I will take 6. How, sir, 6? Very simple. 1 chromium oxidation state changes from plus 6 to plus 3. So 2 chromiums, here 2 chromiums, no? Here 2 chromiums, no? So for 1 chromium, 3 electron transfer. Who are you to say that, sir, only 3 electron transfer? No, you are wrong. Are you thinking like that? So each chromium here plus 6, here each chromium is plus 3. So in 1 chromium plus 6 to plus 3 means difference is 3. So 2 chromiums means 6 is the difference. Correct? Like that. Here 1 chlorine is there. Here 2 chlorines are there. So here I have to put 2. What I did, I was balanced other than hydrogen and oxygen. What I did, understood? So this is a very, very important. So K2Cr2O7 and converted to CrCl3, other than oxygen and remaining atoms, I was. So here potassium is not there, so I was not balanced here. I will balance potassium also later, finally. I will balance water also. Water means oxygen and hydrogen also, finally. Don't think about those two right now. Okay, you will get confused. That's why, to simplify and to make you more easier, I was written only reduction half and oxidation half. Why this is oxidation half, understood? Because minus 1 to 0. Oxidation state. What happened? Increase. So here, this is oxidation half actually. In this, what is the total change in charge? Total change in charge. I will say 2. Everybody have to accept. Okay, sir. We will accept. Why we will accept? 1 chlorine minus 1 to 0. So 2 chlorines are there. 1 chlorine minus 1. 2 chlorines minus 2. Minus 2 to 0. So 2 electron transport or not? So 2. So to equalize now, I have to cross multiply. Generally, I will cross multiply. Now here also you can cross multiply. With here 6 and here 2, if I multiply 2, 6 and 6, 2 12. So total charges I have to equalize, I told or not. Before listening this balancing example, you have to write all 6 points, please. That is a very, very important. So I won't do like this. Actually, you can write, it's not a mistake. I will do one thing. What is that? 2 and 6 are multiples to each other. So I can cancel this. 2 ones are and 2 threes are. Correct? I can do this. Now I will cross multiply. So this is the total change in charge in what? Reduction half. So with 3, I will multiply oxidation half. What is oxidation half? This one is oxidation half. With the red color star is oxidation half. Why I was multiplied, why I kept star, understood? So with this 3, I will multiply. Now no confusion for me. So with 1, I will multiply because this 1 is the total change in charge in oxidation half. So with 1, I have to multiply reduction half. Ulta, cross multiply, told or not? That we have to. Hope you understood. So this is the first thing we did, and now here second, and now the third. What I do, so with 3, what I multiply, this HCl and Cl2, that's why I kept star to avoid confusion. So wherever I have star, there I will multiply with 3. So sir, here also something you give, sir, some like this, you give, sir, like this means, so like this you give, sir, some symbol means I will give like that. No need actually, with 1, remaining was that only now, so no need of symbols. So can you do that now, with 1 means nothing, so same. K2Cr2O7 plus now 2 3s 6 HCl and gives rise to 1 chromium is there, no? So 2 CrCl3 plus and here 6 3 Cl2 like this you have to balance. Okay. Now, you write down remaining also. Till here you understood, I think so. So, K2Cr2O7, HCl and CrCl3 and HCl. What, where I was multiplied? Here HCl and Cl, I was multiplied with 3. With 1, this is the total change in charge in particular oxidation half. So, with 1, I have to multiply reduction half. Sorry, reduction half means here to here. So now I will write remaining also. So I will write remaining also. Remaining means what? I will write water, H2O and as well as Mr. KCl. So now how to balance remaining atoms by just checking with some suitable numbers. Okay? So, I will just use some numbers here. See here, 2 potassiums are there. So, I will use 2 here. Like that I do. And come to oxygens. Here 7 oxygens are there. Here 1, that means 7 H2O. Like that. I'll use some suitable numbers to balance, that's it. Okay? Trial and error method we call that. Okay? So here 7. Now everything got balanced or not means you will say not balanced. 7 2s are 14. But here only 6 is there. So 14 I have right. See, now it will be balanced. 7 2s are 14 hydrogens. So in previous year 6 is there. I have to change it as 14 because 14 hydrogens required in reactants. So now everything got balanced or not? So 2 potassiums, 2 potassiums. 7 oxygens, 7 oxygens. 2 chromiums, 2 chromiums. Chlorines you have to check. 2 3s are 6. 3 2s are 6. Here 2 chlorines. Total 12. Correct? Oh, total 14. 2 3s are 6. 3 2s are 6. 6 plus 6? 12. 12 plus 2? Right? 14 over. So everything got balanced. Hydrogens. 14, 7 to 0, 14. Everything got balanced. This is a balanced equation now. This is oxidation number method. Sir, you was not balanced hydrogen by adding H plus ions. You was not balanced oxygen by adding water molecules. Means I told you when you have to use those two points. When you have ions. When you have ions in reactant side and product side. Hope you understood this example. So similar way, okay, this is balanced equation. You have to try, okay, example 2, you have to try P4, okay, plus, okay, I will give without ions. P plus, with ions I will do, P plus HNO3 gives rise to HPO3 plus NO plus H2O, like this they given. So you have to balance by using oxidation number method. This equation you have to balance, this redox reaction you have to balance. So HPO3 is oxidation. HNO3, that nitrogen convert, nitrogen is plus 5 here, here nitrogen is plus 2. So nitrogen undergone reduction. So this is reduction half and this is oxidation half. So this you can balance. Okay. So how to balance charge you have to understand mainly. Got it, sir, everyone? So first this point everybody knows. Here what I did, total charge change you have to know. That is very, very important. I'll repeat. Please just listen carefully. Other than oxygen and hydrogen, I was balanced. Here 2 chromiums. Here 1 chromium is there previously, so I kept 2. Same. 2 chlorines here, 1 chlorine here, so I kept 2. So total charge difference or total change in charge is 6. Why? Each chromium here plus 6, here chromium is plus 3. So each chromium 3 electron transfer, 3 electron gain because reduction it is, plus 6 converted to plus 3. So 6 minus 3, 3 is the difference. So 2 chromiums, so 6 is the difference. Similarly, 1 chlorine minus 1, minus 1 to 0. But 2 chlorides, 2 Cl minus converted to Cl2. It's 2 electron transfer or not? 2 Cl minus converted to Cl2. That means each chlorine minus 1. 2 chlorines means minus 2 or not? That means how many electron transfer? 2 electron transfer. So 2. Generally, I can cross multiply. Means with 6, I can multiply these 2. With 6, I can multiply these 2. With 2, I can multiply these 2. Like this. But I was not done like that. What I did, 2 and 6 are multiples to each other. So I was simplified first. 2 1s are 2, 3s are 6. So with 3, this 3 is the change in charge in reduction half. So with 3, I have to multiply oxidation half. Oxidation half. So with 3. So I did here. Previous I did. Okay. So afterwards, I changed it as a 14 here. Okay. Previously here 6 is there. I was multiplied 3 2s are 6. So 6 later on, I was converted as 14 here. Understood? Otherwise, just go back. You can understand. Okay, so here one is the change in oxidation half. So with one, I have to multiply this one and this one. So as it is, I get here what you have, same I have here. But it's a, that is the total charge difference. How to know? Total charge difference I can say, or total change in charge I can say. Difference is nothing but change or not. So the same you can say, charge difference, cross multiply is it. While cross multiply, I kept some star. Why I told you already, I won't waste time. So this is the way to have some what balancing of redox reaction by using oxidation number method when there was no ions. All are molecules here. Here reactants are molecules. Here products also molecules. We done one reaction, and we will discuss one more reaction which consists of ions. Okay, let's see that now only. Okay, so please try this one. Phosphorus example I was given. So you have to try and you have to send in our WhatsApp group. And one more important thing today I'll tell you, especially our students, okay, have to. We are uploading videos in YouTube, so anybody can see the those videos, anybody can watch, but you have to watch when our we said, when we said you have to start watching at 9:30 sharp. But if you are not at all watching videos at 9:30, they are wasting time and slowly, okay, nobody will observe, we will watch later, later. Don't do that one. Please, okay, make sure this is for you. You have to understand why we are doing this, okay? You should be more serious, okay? Now, example 2, you have to do, I said. Now, example 3, which consists of ions. So, MnO4 minus plus Fe plus 2. Fe plus 2 is converted to in acidic medium, Mn plus 2 and Fe plus 3. This you have to balance. Same story, first oxidation state of manganese I will calculate here, plus 7. Here manganese is a plus 2. Here iron is a plus 2 and here iron is plus 3. Correct? So there was nothing given like oxygens, whether they're in product side or not. There was not given water like that. Now we have to balance oxygen by adding water molecules. You have to balance hydrogen by adding H plus ions, because in reactant side and product side you have ions. Is it clear? So very, very important. Please, okay, go through this and practice more. Certainly, definitely, one point, at certain point you will have some confusion, but we have to avoid all our confusions. I'm there, so please ask me, I'll explain. Okay, so here plus 7 converted to plus 7. Manganese oxidation state changed or not? Plus 7 converted to plus 2. So this is oxidation, right? Oxidation or reduction? Oh my god, this is reduction. Frankness. Shit. This is reduction half. Because oxidation state reduced or not? Here plus 2 converted to plus 3. So this is oxidation half or not? So two steps I followed. First I was calculated oxidation states. I identified oxidation half and reduction half. Again I will write. This is the first point and this is the second point. Only 3 points. Very easy or not? So MnO4 minus and Fe plus 2 and converted to Mn 2 plus and Fe plus 3, like this given. So as I said, here 2, here is reduction half. Reduction half. So here manganese is a plus 7. Here the manganese is a plus 2. Here iron is a plus 2. Here iron is plus 3. Correct? Huh? So I'll write here, no problem. Because change in charge better to understand. Okay? So here iron is plus 2. Here iron is plus 3. So this conversion, you can say, what is this? Oxidation half. Okay. Now what I do? You shall same story. Total change in charge is 5. Correct now? 7, 2. Difference is 5 or not? The manganese plus 7. Have to calculate oxygen instead of manganese here? Only that? You cannot say. So manganese is a plus 7 here. Manganese is a plus 2. So 5 electron transfer. Here plus 2 and here plus 3. So what is the total change? Write down clearly, no problem. Total change in charge is 1. Simply 1. So minus 1 or plus 1, don't ask me, sir. 3 minus 2, minus 1, no sir. Change I want, difference I want. That's it. Okay, now what I will do? 5, 1. So very simple. You have to cross multiply. So with 5, what I will multiply? Oxidation half. Because this 5 change in reduction half or not. So I will multiply. You also keep some stars like it. So that sometimes by mistake 5 we will write here. See, this 5 we have used for iron actually. Because this 5 is the change in reduction half. This 5 is the change in manganese. So with 5 we have to multiply iron. Okay, that I will do now. So what I will do? Cross multiply. Cross multiply. So what I will do? MnO4 minus, because 1 only. So here 1 and here 1. I will fix in my mind. Because I kept star for these two. So for remaining I have to multiply with 1 or not. So right, that's it. So plus, this is not visible properly, so I'll write like this. MnO4 minus plus 5 Fe plus 2 is converted to Mn plus 2 plus 5 Fe 3 plus. Why we did like that, understood? You can understand. Because charge we are cancelling in both the oxidation half and reduction half. That only we are cross multiplying. Okay. Next fourth step is, of course we have total 6 steps, but one short is like this. Balancing of oxygen and hydrogen. I'll balance oxygen by adding water molecules. I'll do in one step only. Here how many oxygens are there? 4. Here how many oxygens are there? Nothing. So 4 water molecules I have to add in product side. As you know, balancing of oxygen by adding water molecules. So what I'll do here? MnO4 minus plus 5 Fe plus 2 gives rise to Mn plus 2 plus 5 Fe plus 3 plus 4H2O. Why I written 4H2O, understood? Because here 4 oxygens are there. How many oxygens are there? 4. So in product side there should be a 4 oxygens or none. That's why 4 water molecules. Now balancing of hydrogen I will do here only. Otherwise I will use one more step. You want? I will use, no problem. Now fifth step if you want. So balancing of hydrogen. What I will do? Very simple. 4 to 0. 8 hydrogens in product side. What medium? Acidic medium. You have to add H plus ions. In which side? Which side hydrogens are less? Here 8 hydrogens in product side. In reactant side there is no hydrogen. So in reactant side you have to add 8 H plus. Here all I can write. But one more step just for understanding. So what I can write? MnO4 minus plus 5 Fe 2 plus plus 8 H plus is gives rise to Mn plus 2 plus 5 Fe plus 3 plus 4H2O. Like this you can write. Now everything got balanced. You can check now. Manganese, manganese. 4 oxygens, 4 oxygens. 8 hydrogens, 8 hydrogens. Charge also you can check. Minus 1, 5 2s are plus 10 and plus 8. Here plus 2 plus 5 3s are 15. So here charge got balanced or not, you can check. So 18 minus 1. 17. 15 plus 2, 17. Charge also got balanced. You can check. What I did understood? Minus 1, 5 2s are plus 10, 8 into plus 1, plus 2, 5 3s are plus 15. So everything got balanced or not? So this is the balancing of redox reaction by oxidation number method when ions are present. Two examples I was given. So please practice. One example I was given, you have to balance that. Okay? Please practice all these things carefully.